All these bloody questions.
It's an interview.
Yeah, well then. I mean, I'm no expert. I'm just a guy who does art. I'm sure there's some people who really look at art and really think about it, but I just do it. There's not much of a thought process about how religion has been depicted throughout the ages. I am a pious man. No, I'm not. So, what the fuck do you want me to say, George?
Art is exclusive, it's rich, and it's confusing. The art world exists in its own little bubble with amateurs and professionals, and the critics and the conservatives. Through conversation with such artistic figureheads, this documentary shall establish. That's how strong my love is.
Get a nice dose of variation in your mouth.
Don't tell me to never put my laptop on my lap or radio on my dip.
That's called a laptop.
Come on then, can we start doing tap dance?
How often do you do this?
When half moon, full moon.
When
trouble with the classicist.
The people of the Shire. They tell me. We're the job.
I tell the classicist. He looks at the sky.
Not a fucking slave, man.
Saint Peter is a graffiti artist living in England. His work differs from the rest of the genre by depicting normal traditional paintings as graffiti. He is disliked by both the graffiti art community and the traditional conservative art community for stealing the traditional works by other artists.
Why St. Peter?
He's our Lord.
He's the true Jesus Christ.
He's
a liar, man.
He isn't the true one. St. Peter was the reincarnation of Jesus, and I am the reincarnation of St. Peter.
So do you regard...
making me the son of God.
Do you regard this as kind of like your mission?
A missionary in a form, yeah.
Promoting your dad.
They call me the cabin missionary.
Often criticised as being superficial, St. Peter regards that he is completely honest in his depictions of the saint and his meaning behind it. His latest works, he's pasted depictions of the saint on hearted areas as a means for spreading his ideology. As a result, he has captured the interest of contemporary artists around the world.
I'd say that often delusional, but perhaps there are some who can do something good with their art. I mean, art can be a means of education, and in that regard I suppose I can very loosely support them.
Then it's good, but it's time to give back.
Having had no artistic training and with his work showing no artistic skill, St. Peter's work is solely based off of its meaning, a cornerstone in the justification of modern art.
I owed you £10 for last night's colours.
They get a lot of criticism.
Modern art, or conceptual art, isn't art at all. It's one big circle jerk of pretentious twats trying to make themselves look sophisticated by ascribing meaning to something that's completely meaningless. When you see someone intently staring at a Jackson Pollock-style vomit canvas, they're not really trying to ascertain its deeper meaning. It's all just an act to prove to the other pompous wankers that they're part of the same cult of aesthetic relativism.
What do you find bad about modern art? Is it the fact that it doesn't have any technical ability? Or what would you say?
Well, I think art is generally useless.
Why?
I am myself an artist. And yet I only do that for myself. There's no other reason to do art.
Although St. Peter's work has been criticised as being the worst modern art has to offer, the opposing conservative argument has its flaws also.
Okay.
I did plenty of things. Last week, I went on the street of New York and I got naked. Sort of be a bit weird. Seems to be the art that gets the most attention these days. I am someone who wants to be loved. He wants to be famous. So I've no love for Van Gogh because he was famous when he died, and there's no fulfillment in that. So I make art that is popping, that you will see on your Facebook homepage as you scroll down. My art will be that 5-second video that will catch your attention, because that's what I need to do.
Willis Fitzgerald became famous after a video of his piece, Book 2, went viral on Facebook. Having spent years training as a classical illustrator, his work presents genuine artistic skill and talent, whilst using simple tools such as pens and pencils to complete his work. In his lectures, he regards that his work should not be taken seriously, but should be enjoyed, that there is no deeper meaning to his work. Yet many say that subconsciously he has attached meaning by not doing so.
Objects. And if you just allow an object or an architectural design to be as it is, uh-huh. as its material state, then it can be anything to anyone. Whereas if you have a focus on what a design is meant to be, then it is going to be that for everyone. Because it has a focus. So if you say, if you predetermine what something is, like, it's always going to be that. I mean, the way people perceive it will be slightly different, but the main background is always going to be there. Whereas if you just give someone something and not tell them anything about it, then it will be a complete result of what they've experienced in their lives and nothing else.
Like I said, I'm entirely selfish, so I fulfill my own wants and needs, and my own need is to sit down, buy a canvas and paint something. That's what I enjoy doing. Maybe it's not so bad that I do that. Maybe it is. It must be bad, because other people can't fulfill those same needs and wants that I can when I go in my art studio. But then I do art that is more of a self-reflection, if I begin to justify myself for why I do it, which I don't show people. And that's the art that I suppose is real. But getting naked in the street, that's not really art, it's a means to be famous.
In truth, for the public, art is a way of seeing the world through somebody else's eyes. And the iffy complexities of the art world is benign, rather than creating what they think is a correct depiction of true beauty of nature. Artists should focus on the world around them and the beauty that is natural environments. Their work, frankly, takes the piss.
Anyone who ever had a heart wouldn't turn around and break it. And anyone who's ever played a part wouldn't turn around and hate it.